Nobody has to tell you how bad things are because men haven't kept their promises, but a change has begun.
I'd asked Bill McCartney to speak at a banquet in Pueblo.
We had a 3-hour ride ahead of us. And I asked Dave this question. I said, Dave, if you could do one thing with your life, what would it be? He said, without hesitation, he said, Bill, my calling is to be one-on-one with men.
Dave, he was envisioning discipleship. Coach was envisioning stadiums down the road, stadiums full of men.
72 men came together.
That was 1990. In 1991, 4,200 men came. A year later, there were 22,000 promise keepers. In 1993, the numbers swelled to 50,000. Then, 1994.
Promise Keepers, I praise God for them. This is the first time I've ever been to the Promise Keepers, and I see the awesomeness of all these men coming together in one group.
Whatever your denomination, whatever your occupation, whatever your race, we've come together not by accident, but by the prodding of God.
Man, God today is giving us an opportunity. He is giving you an opportunity to seize the moment.
Do you serve your wife? Do you serve your children? The best leaders are servant leaders.
I didn't understand what it meant to be a father or a husband. I didn't want my kids looking back and saying, man, I wish my dad was a godly dad, and I wish my dad would have done it God's way.
And by going to the Promise Keepers event with my son, I was hearing things that we both need to talk about.
Promise Keepers has been a life changer for me.
You are a part of one of the greatest spiritual movements, and we are not behind time. We have come in the fullness of time.
Is raise the standard. And in turn, we will raise the standard of what it means to be a true man. We will be men through humility with great strength and provide spiritual initiative in our homes. We will raise the standard of what it means to be a man in the community.
I think it's important that men get together and share.
So we made a commitment.
This last year, we've met most every week.
52 weeks.
You know, he's got my best concerns at heart, and he's willing to say something that I might not like if he thinks it's the best thing for me.
To be with a bunch of group of men is exciting because I never seen something like this before.
I've never been around 52,000 people before, and I mean, it blew me away.
I really feel the presence of the Lord here.
The best part was when everyone was joining hands together and showing brotherly love with one another.
Thank God for Jesus.
A truth to assume leadership
in mentoring is
a by the power of the resurrected Christ.
There's a breakdown in the family that's affecting our society.
He's looking for men who will be exceptional men. Gentlemen, let's be those men, because Jesus is in control. He'll give us the victory.
We have been called to take the gospel to our culture.
Sometime you have to seize the moment, and you have to say, I'm calling out for Jesus Christ.
The power of a promise is incredible. This is called Promise Keepers, not just Promise Makers.
We need our clergy to open up the scriptures to us.
They need us to hug them, to embrace them, to support them.
If God is your father, then I'm your brother.
There is no time left for racism. There is no time left for culturalism. There is no time left